Hi, you guys. I miss you so much. I hope you're all doing well. I thought that we could today work on getting creative in a composition class. So I'm going to give you a couple exercises that you can do on your own to create your own choreography at home. You don't need a lot of space. If you have a lot of space, great. If you don't, also great. Because one of the beautiful things about creating work is using the space that you have. It's actually one of our elements that we're working with today. So we're going to be thinking about shape, space, level, time, and energy today. So those are five elements that are really key, important elements when creating choreography. And you know, it's funny because a lot of times you don't even necessarily consciously think of them, but you're using them even when you're not thinking of them. So today we're going to just, like I said, work on a couple exercises that I hope you really enjoy. And I would love if you want to share with me what you what you come up with. So if you are on social media, you could hashtag BVMP Keep Dancing, or you could just send me, have your mom or Dad or whoever text me or email me and send me what you've been working on if you want to share. Also, you could just keep this for yourself because this is for you. So, first exercise I want to do today, and this is one that you all have loved in the past, is spell your name. So, you remember how to, oh, can you hear Hendrix? He's downstairs. So to spell your name, it's just that, right? We're gonna use our bodies to spell our name. So since you guys are old pros with this, what I want you to do is pick a body part. It could be your elbow, could be your belly button, could be your nose, could be your toes, anything. And I want that body part to lead when you spell your name. So let's see you do it. Spell that name for me.
Thank you.
job. Now what I want you to do with that is apply these elements that we were talking about, okay? I want you to think about space, the given space that you're working with, right? How did you fit your name in that space? Then I want you to think about levels, right? So are we going high, middle, low? I'd love for you to apply all of those levels. Can we make it high, middle, and low at different points when we're spelling our name? And energy, time. I'm gonna list all of these for you so that you can take a look at what you're working with. So what I want you to do is I want you to just write. It could be anything, whatever's on your mind, okay? So it might seem totally wacky, right? Because we have a lot of thoughts always going through our mind. Don't judge it, just let it be. Write it out, okay? It could be I'm hungry, I'm bored, I wonder what's going to happen later today. You know, just write. Because then when we're done writing, we're gonna go back and read it just by yourself. This is just for you. We're going to go back and we're going to read it, and I'm going to have you circle key words, words that stuck out to you, words that stick out to you and seem exciting or inspiring. So I want you to take some time and just write. Just sit with yourself quietly and write. Thank you. So now comes a time to go through and circle any keywords that stick out to us that are exciting, okay? So again, no one's gonna see this, just go ahead, circle some words. Take those words that you circled, and I want you to try and think of a complete thought involving those words, even if they're unrelated, okay? I want you to try and think of like a really short or simple storyline involving those words. It could be one sentence or four sentences, whatever you need to tell your story, okay? So circle those words, right? We've got that, and we're going to try and bring them together.
Thank you.
know you're doing a great job. Now, next up, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take some of the movement from the name phrase, okay? So you don't have to use the whole thing, all right? And remember, you can always do this exercise with any word. You could just choose a word and spell it out. You can do it with anything, but we'll take the movement from our name. And what I want you to do is expand on it. Okay, so take a look at how you can bring together the movement from your name with what you've written down, okay, in your stream of conscious thought. Okay guys, so what I'd like you to do is find an object around your room or in the house. Make sure it's something you're allowed to have. Okay, so ask your parents, please. It could be anything, really literally anything. Okay, it could be a remote control, be a wooden spoon, it could be a pillow, you name it, as long as it's not fragile or breakable. What I'd like you to do is take a random object, okay? And I'd like you to incorporate it into what we've just done. All right, so we've got our movement with our names, right? Our name movement. And then we have our story, our short storyline we created. And now we've introduced the element of a an object, okay, or prop. So what I want you to do is get creative with that and see how you can incorporate that, okay? And so take your time and do that. So, how to go? Cool? All right, cool. And you know, this is something that you, like I said, you can share it with me, or your family, or you can keep it to yourself. It's for you. It's just an exercise and, you know, expressing yourself and getting creative. And there are so many different ways we can do this. So I just wanted to, you know, touch back on some exercises we've done before in class, to refresh your memory. And, you know, we'll go further with this, okay? So if you like this, let me know if you liked doing this today, and we can expand on it and do some new exercises as well. And that's it, you guys. I hope you have fun. Keep creating, keep expressing yourselves, keep moving, keep dancing, keep making music, keep just, you know, tapping into all those things that make us feel good, all right? Can't wait to see you as soon as we can, and have a great day, you guys. Thanks for dancing with me.